a man who put it in my hood. It's got me singing melodies I never thought I would. I'm feeling sorry for the homies who be smoking wood. Chop, chop, break it down for a player like yee, 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 yee. I'm about to find me a woman and ski, 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 ski. I'ma keep smoking till I reach my peak, 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 peak. Or till I'm stuck and my body feels weak, 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 weak. Headed down to the dungeon wondering if they got some more. And if they don't, then I'ma have to settle for some draw. Better just stay cool, cause right on after I'ma have to go and continue on my mission. Fishing for the yum yum, but I'm moving slow.
Get your life, roll it sticky, let's get higher.
Let's get higher.
Got that blueberry yum yum in the step fire. Get your lighters rolling sticky, let's get higher.
Let's get higher.
Got that blueberry yum yum and it's that fire.
It's that fire.
Yeah. Fire, fire, got me so tired, I'ma stop, drop, and roll. Put a wet towel under the door. Don't pass it, I can't take it no more. Somebody take a trip down to the store. Hurry please, cause I need some snacks, 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 snacks. Will it take to get back, 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 back? Yes, indeed, I'm a little off track, 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 track. Off this weed and I'm full of that yak, yak, yak. Get on in that stank and lankin, crank it up and ride. And it ain't enough room to fit the other chicks inside. I'm so hungry with the munchies, I'ma eat everything inside. Me and my blueberries together and everything's alright.
Get your lighters rolling sticky, let's get high,
let's get high.
Got that blueberry yum yum and it's that fire.
It's that fire.
Get your lighters rolling sticky, let's get higher.
Let's get higher.
Got that blueberry yum yum and it's that fire.
It's that fire.
Get the propane rolling things and let's blow this place up. You already know what's up. I might have had to pay some extra bucks, but I really don't give a fuck. My brother feels great, 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 but I'm barely awake, wake, 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 wake. I'll get out of shape, 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 shape. So stomp on your break, 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 break. If you told me good, then all the smoke guys, let me see your flame. Don't know what you got, but my bag will put your stuff to shame. All the different kinds and other flavors, they don't mean a thing. You can't compare it, don't stare, cause I got the ultimate marriage.
Get your lighters rolling sticky, let's get higher.
Let's get higher.
Got that blueberry yum yum and it's that fire.
It's that fire.
Get your lighters rolling sticky, let's get higher.
Let's get higher.
Got that blueberry yum yum and it's that fire.
Is there hope for weed ever being legalized in the United States? What's your philosophy on that?
The reason drugs are illegal is because of the politicians have to scream to something, you know?
That was ludicrous with blueberry yum yum. Fucking, we're gonna get into... This is like my cousin's only smoking song. I'm really disappointed in that. Because if you're listening, I don't know if you smoke like that right now, but whenever I go to Detroit, we getting you high as fuck. We getting you high as fuck. I'm going to have Ditzy with me. We'll bring E-Rock. We're going to roll a big old fat Cheech and Chonger. Getting you high. This is Eminem with Must Be the Ganja. Big shout out to my big cousin Eminem. Check it out.
Yeah. Oh, oh. Yeah, yeah. Oh, I feel like dancing. I feel like dancing. I smell something in the air that's making me high. I said I smell something in the air that's making me high.
Okay, here we go.
Do re mi fa so fa sol la ti da so. Lyrical Roscoe, kick back a Tabasco. You motherfuckers, monkeys not know the TikTok song. Time to show you the monkey ass flow in the cosmos. Picasso with a pickaxe, a sick asshole. Tic-tac-toe, punch a six-pack with Exacto. Knives, strangling wives with thick lasso. Big bags of the grass, zigzags, I'm with the dazzo. You know how that goes, skull in the crossbones. This is poison to boys and girls who do not know. You do not wanna try this at home, my lovato. This is neither the time nor the place to get macho. So crack a six pack, sit back with some nachos. Maybe some popcorn and watch the show and just rock slow. not what you expected, nor what you thought. So about time that you wake the fuck up, smell the pot.
It must be the ganja, it's the marijuana that's creeping up on me. Why I'm so high? Maybe it's the Henny that has gotten in me. Whatever's got into me, I don't mind. It's the ganja, it's the marijuana that's creeping up on me. Why I'm so high? Maybe it's the Henny that has gotten in me. Whatever's got into me, I don't mind.
Your dreams are getting fulfilled. Ooh, I'm literally getting the chill, spitting at will. Me and Dre have just finished splitting the pill. You're submitting to skill, sitting still. I'm admitting I'm beginning to feel like I don't think anyone's real. Faced with a dilemma, I can be Dalai Lama and be karma, bring drama, a step beyond a Jeffrey Dahmer. Please don't upset me, mama. You're looking sexy, mama. Don't know if it's the lala or the rum and Pepsi, mama. Don't wanna end up inside my refrigerator freezer. Be used as extra topping the next time I make a pizza. How many people you know who can name every serial killer who ever existed in a row? Put them in chronological order, beginning with Jack the Ripper. Name the time and place from the body, the bag, the zipper. Location of the woods where the body was dragged and then dumped. The trunk that they were stuffed in, the model to make the plate, and which model would select the founder and how to attack the victim. Say which murder weapon was used to do what and which one. Which knife and which gun. What kid would wipe and which nun. Don't stop, I like this, it's fun. The fucking nice to see gun.
It must be the ganja, it's the marijuana that's creeping up on me. Why I'm so high? Maybe it's the Henny that has gotten in me. Whatever's got into me, I don't mind. It's the ganja, it's the marijuana that's creeping up on me. Why I'm so high? Maybe it's the Henny that has gotten in me. Whatever's got into me, I don't mind.
When I'm behind a mic, dynamite's what it's kinda like. You're stuck with the same stick that you're trying to light. Behind the boards, it's Dre. Legends are made this way. Isn't it safe to say this is the way it should be? Maybe you need some lyric syrup some for your symptoms. Here's a dosage of the antidote, now you give him some. He can give her some, she can give them some. Get behind a Lindrum, make up a beat and kill the sucker syndrome. The spinning drum when it comes to lyrics and pinning some. Starting from scratch and then ending up at the ending of. Capable of winning a Pulitzer, so unbelievable it's a titanium cranium that's full of sir. Prizes when the smoke rises right before your very own eyes. You're staring to your stereos. Good evening, this isn't even a weed thing. I ain't even smoke anything, I ain't even drinking.
It must be the ganja, it's the marijuana that's creeping up on me. Why I'm so high? Maybe it's the Henny that has gotten in me. Whatever's got into me, I don't mind. It's the ganja, it's the marijuana that's creeping up on me. Why I'm so high? Maybe it's the Henny that has gotten in me. Whatever's got into me, I don't mind.
That was Eminem with Must Be the Ganja. Big shout out to my big cousin Eminem. Holding it down. He's still doing his tour right now, rocking it. Got motherfucking Obi Trice with him. Big shout out to everyone in Detroit holding it down. We did our Cali to Detroit episode last night. Had E-Rock on. Great fucking show. I love what we got E-Rock on, man, because he's a dude that I could sit here and smoke a blunt and fucking politic with. Like, there's homies I can smoke a blunt with anyone. But then there's, you know, there's certain people you smoke a blunt and it's just, hey, y'all ain't gonna talk about shit. You're gonna sit there and just smoke back and forth all day. Or hear them talk about their life problems. Or just bullshit without meaning. Like, then there's those people you could sit down and y'all spark a blunt and y'all could plot the world takeover or fucking politic on music or whatever, man. Like, it's just all fucking, it clicks, man. Those are fucking good people to smoke with, good people to keep in your circle right there. Like I was talking to E-Rock about last night, you know, I read in Forbes magazine, if you don't have like-minded friends, if your friends aren't sitting there talking about how to get money or how to level up, you need new friends. And that's real shit. That's real shit, Nick. You know, the best way to figure that out is smoke a blunt with someone. Because even reserved people, you smoke a blunt with them, and it'll come out, their true intentions or, you know, at least how they are. You'll be able to see how they really are that way. I actually want to do a TV show like that I'm planning on doing pretty soon. I'm not going to give the full details because I don't want no one stealing my idea, but you'll see some happening. You know, I like how Joe Rogan does his podcast that way. I was watching, he had Alex Jones on there flipping the fuck out, but he gets people high as shit before they start their interviews. He gets people high as fuck right there in the studio, and then is like, all right, start talking. And just has these motherfuckers just rant about all sorts of crazy shit. Had Alex Jones on there talking about the aliens making deals with Nazis and shit. Like, just crazy shit, man. But we're going to get into some Wiz Khalifa. Big shout out to, oh no, this isn't Wiz, never mind. This one here is Roll Up, but I hate when this fucking thing wants to just automatically assume what artist the fucking shit is when I upload it to the studio. This is actually my dude, G Battles. Big shout out to G Battles. He was rocking on Four Flavors with me for a while when we were with Four Flavors Entertainment. Big shout out to my Uncle Forte. And just so people know, because I've gotten a few questions, you call him Uncle Forte, is that your real uncle? No, he's not my real uncle, of course. I'm white and he's black, but no, he's not related to Eminem, too. It's fucking, I get so tired of those people asking about my family tree and shit. I call him Uncle Forte because that's what everyone calls him. Like, that's how he is. He was everyone on the labels. Like, he's that cool uncle that's just there for you, down for you and shit. You know what I mean? And, big shout to Forte. Big shout to Mrs. Forte as well. They got their baby on the way. They're fucking just moved. Got some good things going on in life, man. Life is good for them. So, big shout out to them. But, big shout out to my dude, G Battles. G Battles, you know, I met him when I first got signed with Forte. We were at Lake Havasu, Arizona, spring break. This time of year, a few years back, met G Battles up there, man. And we were up there smoking on the balcony of these college kids let us party in their hotel room and shit. We had Forte with us, so we were just partying with everyone. It's like probably 4 in the morning. We drunk as shit, high as a motherfucker. But not to the point where we're hallucinating. So I know what we saw was real because other people saw that shit. He looks up, he says, hey, you see that shit? I said, what? And I look up, and there's a UFO. Motherfuckers don't believe this story to this day. There's a UFO. G Battle recorded that shit on his phone. He tried to put that shit on Facebook, and Facebook kept deleting the shit. Wouldn't let him post it. It's fucking crazy, but yeah. It's fucking UFO. The same night I got signed by Forte and was kicking with G Battles. Talking about life and music and shit. Man, you know, G Battle's always been showing love ever since then, though. He came back out to Arizona when I was out in Phoenix. Fucking, we went down to Comerica Theater. We were gonna do some shit out there, but then that fucking company that took over the Hip Hop Awards in Arizona, Respect the Underground, as I call them, Raping the Underground. Because these motherfuckers will sit there. That's the issue. I'm gonna go on a rant here for a minute. Let me spark this motherfucking shit up real quick. We're about to go on a rant real quick. No. This is why Arizona didn't make it when they were the talk of the industry. There was a lot of talk in the industry at one point in time. Arizona was supposed to be the next Hollywood. It was going to be the next Atlanta, the next hotspot, the next fucking hub for entertainment. People got selfish. People got greedy. Fucked it all up. The real industry packed up and left. They said, fuck it. Packed up and left. But you know what? The real ones out there still kept pushing. And that was cool, you know, keep pushing for your city. But at the same time, there's a lot of fucked up shit going on in the scene. And then this company called Respect the Underground, they get in with the mayor of Phoenix, make a hip-hop day. And everyone's like, oh, cool, they're going to have hip-hop day like in Atlanta down here. We think it's all going to be like fucking about the history of hip-hop and shit. So I have Forte's people come down, G Battles down there with me. We going up there. Dude knows that I got G Battles from Forte's camp with me. He won't even shake his hand. He looks him up and down. He's like, so? I'm like, what the fuck? Come to find out this hip-hop day isn't even about hip-hop. It's about let's all pay this dude justice from raping the underground to feel like we're a part of something. And the day is going to be all about him. He fucking says, oh, I got this show at Comerica Theater. We go down there thinking we're going to be inside Comerica Theater. Motherfucker didn't even have the inside. He's like, oh, our stage is around the side here. I'm like, what do you mean our stage? He's like, yeah, it's a secret stage. I'm like, secret stage? We go up. He got everyone performing on. It's not even a stage. It's that little, you know, that levee behind buildings where they back trucks up to and shit. And there's that, like, ledge. People were performing on that shit in the outside in the back parking lot. I look at G Battles like, you even want to do this? He shook his head. No, I was like, fuck that, bro. As your manager, as management, we dipping the fuck out. We went to the strip club, partied the fuck up, had a great night. Big shout out to G Battles. But we're going to get into this track here. This is Roll Up featuring Little Nate Dogg. I like this song. It's got Nate Dogg's son on it.